In the year 2035, a project called Artificial Intelligence Cellular Organism, or AICO, had gone wrong in a private research lab called Kurobiotech. This resulted in a phenomenon people called the burst, wherein a synthetic slime-like organism called malignant matter, or simply matter, got loose and infested the city. This place was incredibly dangerous and inhabitable, and only trained people called divers with special protective and combative equipment were permitted to enter. 2 years after the burst, Aiko Tachibana, an orphaned high school girl, was knocked off of her wheelchair in the middle of a PE game. Weirdly enough, the scratch she acquired from her fall healed almost immediately. One day, Aiko and her friends rush to class at full speed as they are about to be late, when in the hallway, a boy suddenly appears. Aiko falls off her wheelchair onto him and their wrists touch. Suddenly, Aiko saw flashbacks to her past, in class. Despite it being the last day of school, the teacher introduced a new student named Yuuya Kanzaki. Kanzaki was the boy Aiko fell into in the hallway. Aiko gapes at him, and for some reason unknown to her, she is able to stand on her own 2 feet. Back in the hospital room where Aiko lives, her nurse gives her permission to return to her house to retrieve some things. This, however, distresses Aiko, and she hesitates to go. But after being comforted by her friend and motivated by Kanzaki, she decides that she would do it. In her home, she finds the birthday gift her father has given her on the day of a crash that caused his death. She cries as she remembers all the good times she had with her family. Meanwhile, Kanzaki notices that some people are monitoring them and decides to go to Aiko. He tells her that some people are there to take her and they must get away. As they escape, Kanzaki reveals to her that she has the power to put an end to the burst. He takes Aiko to headquarters in town where there are two other men, later revealed to be Shino, a fighter, and Dr. Kurose, one of the doctors that operated on Aiko following her car accident. Superintendent Nambura, director of CAAC, is alerted when Aiko is taken away and immediately arranges a team to retrieve her and capture Kanzaki. Aiko, still confused by everything, asks what all of this means. They explain to her that after her crash, the extent of her injuries were so great that they almost could not revive her. But because of her father working at the Kiryu Research Lab, she was one of the recipients of the research that studied artificial organisms. It turns out that they had a duplicate of her body, and they performed a surgery to separate her brain from her original body to swap it with the brain in the duplicate one. Currently, the body she's living in is an artificial duplicate, explaining why her body automatically heals from any injuries. Kanzaki then explains the operation of the swap, led by Dr. Toshihide Yura, triggered the original burst 2 years ago. Going back to the Kiryu Research Lab, or primary point, aptly named as the origin of the burst, and returning the brains to their original bodies will eradicate the matter and bring things back in order. He also tells Aiko that contrary to what she may have believed, her mother and brother did not die in the burst but are contained in a pod by the matter in an induced coma. Still not trusting everyone fully, Aiko escapes and bumps into a group of people in a diner. However, Shino and Kanzaki catch up with her and take her back. The group that Aiko bumps into turns out to be divers named Kazuki, Sagami Masua, and Sari. Shino and Dr. Kurose hire them to take Aiko. Kanzaki and Shiraishi, a doctor who is with Kanzaki and Dr. Kurose, to primary point. The mission proved to be difficult as they are being requested to go deep into the containment area where no diver has ever returned alive. However, they were paid a handsome payment up front, which was enough to convince them. A loud bang issues from upstairs and they realize that their headquarters is being raided. They run upstairs to find that the seat Aiko had been sitting in is already empty. Aiko is now with the people from the Control Agency of Artificial Creature, or CAAC. The CAAC tells her that Kanzaki lied to her about her mother and brother being alive. Kanzaki was also captured and questioned for kidnapping Aiko and faking his identity to enter the school. The CAAC plans to take Aiko away to another city as she is an important figure in their research. However, Shino and the divers come to her rescue and ambush the CAAC van. During the chase, Aiko has a change of heart and decides to trust Kanzaki that her mother and brother Ryota are still alive. After a bit of trouble with the CAAC, they manage to retrieve Aiko and Kanzaki. They plan their route to the primary point, led by Shino, and they get ready for the equipment for their journey. Shino, Kanzaki, Shiraishi, and Aiko, along with the divers, Kazuki, Sagami, Masawa, and Sari are ready. Dr. Kurose stays and becomes their correspondent, monitoring from the town. Just before their departure, the government announces a civil protection order as the malignant matter activity has spiked. Now, security on the gates gets tighter, but the group manages to pass through before the restrictions are placed. To everyone's surprise, they encounter the matter not far after they exit the gate. After using combat equipment they thought were for the matter deep into the area and a bit of teamwork, they managed to crystallize the matter. Following this first gruesome battle, however, Aiko faints. As they realize that the fight with the matter is going to be more challenging than they have anticipated, the team strategizes once they get into a specialized shelter. As Kazuki is explaining a key part of their mission, he shows a drug that is capable of inhibiting matter activities. Aiko wonders why it resembles the drugs that were administered to her in the Kiryu Hospital. The government is planning to completely annihilate the matter as it's becoming incredibly dangerous, but Superintendent Nanbara of the CAC discourages them, saying that the technology behind the research is invaluable to the country. The team continues their mission and they encounter and fight off more matter. Meanwhile, Dr. Kurose is in the Kuryu lab, talking to Dr. Kiryu, who is in a hospital bed about the Cell Assembler 2, the technology that made Aiko's swap possible. He bumps into Dr. Izasu. They talk about their projects and Dr. Izasu tells him that he has changed his mind about wiping off the matter. In a hospital room, Dr. Izasu sits beside Yazuka, his daughter who is in a coma, saying that he will do all it takes to save her. Meanwhile, the matter is evolving to be more powerful and is taking on a human form. Aiko finds the present given to her by her father. It turns out to be an artificial organism that can come to life. One night, the artificial organism wanders off outside the shelter, and Aiko goes after it. This sends everyone in a panic, and they search for her. Shino eventually finds her and tells her not to wander like that, since she's putting not only her life in danger, but also everyone else's. Kanzaki comes back with Aiko's pet, which was then named Gumi, as suggested by Masawa. Meanwhile, Dr. Izasu and Superintendent Nanbara talk about Dr. Kurose and how they know that he will want to postpone the AICO project before the matter is fully eliminated. Not seeing eye to eye with him on this, they conspire to kick him out of his position behind his back. The further they travel into the path, the harder it becomes to fight and defeat the matter. This time, Misawa had a mishap and the matter got too close to the beetle Aiko was riding before it was taken down. This caused a delay in their schedule since the beetle will take time to repair. While they're stuck, Kanzaki makes Aiko use a device that can link her brain to other brains in the primary point, through dreamlike visions which Kanzaki calls the Active Dream Contract. The team is back on the road again. Like the previous trails, they encounter more variants of matter that they were unable to identify. Out of nowhere, Aiko gains the ability to locate where the matters attack from. With this, she takes the front seat and guides the team where to aim. After they get to safety, Aiko passes out. Later, Kanzaki suspects that this ability may have been caused by the Active Dream Contract. Dr. Izasu confronts Dr. Kurose and tells him that he has been kicked out from the board. When Kanzaki and Shiraishi talk, Kanzaki tells her that he thinks that the other Aiko in the primary point is losing consciousness, which means that they swap surgery might fail, raising the stakes. The tunnel they need to pass is being blocked by a form matter, and adding to that, divers sent by the CAA security forces called Ozanami Squad catch up to them and demand to have Aiko. Kanzaki confronts them and tells them that nothing can stop him from putting an end to the burst. They aim their guns at him, but before they have a chance to pull the trigger, the matter attacks and takes them down. One by one, the matter attacks the Ozanami Squad. The team realizes that the matter has become sensitive to light, and they use that knowledge to devise a plan to escape the tunnel. Finally, they were able to escape. Greatly disturbed by what she saw earlier in the tunnel, Aiko tells Kanzaki that she refuses to risk anyone's safety any longer. Unbeknownst to them, Sari can hear their conversation through the beetle, and although it isn't the whole truth, she discovers that Aiko is in fact an artificial organism and that she was the reason why the matter has been hot on their trail the entire time. Meanwhile, Dr. Kurose and his friend discover that there is another artificial organism like Aiko, and that it was Dr. Izasu's daughter, Yuzuha, and they decide to learn more about it. During one of their fights, the matter was able to get a hold of Aiko, despite the team's best efforts, and stores her in a pod like the ones her mother and brother are in, although she manages to get out and crystallize it. Her true identity is revealed to the team. Kanzaki, Shiraishi, and Shino come clean about Aiko's situation to the team. Although they initially want to abandon the mission, they decide to keep going and do the job they agreed to do in the first place. However, Sagami threatened them that if they try to hide anything more from them, or if they get stuck, he'll end Kanzaki and Shino's life. Dr. Kurose tells Superintendent Nanbara about what he discovered about Dr. Izusu's daughter, Yuzuha. The superintendent was appalled that Izusu has been keeping things from her and she decides to go against him. Following the death of Dr. Kiryu, Dr. Izusu is now the hospital director of Kiryu Research Labs. This makes him gain full access to the files of the lab. He digs up old records and finds that Dr. Yuka is still alive as Yuuya Kanzaki, and the swap surgery was performed by Dr. Kurose. Dr. Kurose relays his discovery about Dr. Izusu's daughter, Yuzuha, to Kanzaki. He also breaks the news about Dr. Kiryu's passing and that Dr. Izisu now takes over as the hospital director. Dr. Kurose revealed to Superintendent Nambura that he was the one who arranged to take Aiko. He explains that Dr. Yura is still alive as Kanzaki, and he's on the mission to end the burst by taking Aiko to primary point and returning the brains to their correct bodies. With this information, Superintendent Nambura decides to side with them. Aiko helps the team fight against the matter by guiding them where to shoot, however, is now seriously affected by the attacks on the matter, feeling their pain as if it was hers. During an intense fight with the matter, Shino valiantly sacrifices himself to save Aiko, Kanzaki, and Shiraishi. He says that there is a purpose in what they do and takes his last breath. Shiraishi and Aiko try to take his body, but it's simply impossible, so Kanzaki drags them and they flee for their lives, weeping for their fallen comrade. They finally arrive at Kiryu Research Lab 2, or Primary Point, where the burst originated. Everything is going smoothly until Dr. Izasu reaches them through a voice signal. There, he reveals to everyone that Kanzaki is actually an artificial organism that Dr. Yura's brain was implanted into, and that Aiko is actually the duplicate brain inside the original body of Aiko Tachibana. And for the burst to be ended, Dr. Yuga will have to kill her. Realizing this, Aiko runs away from the team. Separated from everyone, Aiko, who turns out to be the duplicate Aiko, was surrounded by the matter. But instead of hurting her, the matter opens up into a portal-like gate. Aiko, finding it less than threatening, enters it. There, she meets herself, or rather, the original Aiko in the duplicate body. Upon realizing the whole truth, the team is now fully trusting of Kanzaki, or Dr. Yuka, except for the Kanzaki who passionately confessed that he has developed feelings for the Aiko that they have been traveling with. Kanzaki coldly replies that those feelings are only an illusion. Angered by this, Kanzaki separates from the team and looks for Aiko. Aiko's two selves finally meet, and they talk. The duplicate Aiko is feeling like everything she was made to believe was a lie, and that it's difficult for her to believe that she is only a duplicate as her feelings and memories all feel so real. She thinks that maybe she's not supposed to exist in the first place. The real Aiko consoles her, explaining that she was able to see all her experiences for the past 2 years, and that this is what kept her hopeful despite being alone inside the matter for a very long time. She makes the duplicate Aiko promise to save their mother and brother. After their touching exchange, the duplicate Aiko musters the courage and accepts her fate. She looks for Kanzaki so they could put an end to the burst. Meanwhile, Dr. Yuka realizes that the human form taken by the matter was because of Yuzaha. He enters her consciousness and finds out that she had been stuck there for so long. Soon, he finds out that Dr. Izasu has linked her to many duplicate bodies and that has been causing her to be in a state of a coma. The duplicate Aiko, who has come to terms that she must be sacrificed in order to end everything, reunites with Kanzaki, aka Dr. Yura. The latter apologizes to her, and she tells him that she's ready. Kanzaki confesses to Aiko that he loves her and that he would do everything in his power to keep her from dying. He reveals that he saw through her memories when the matter took his arm on a previous mission. Aiko tells her that it was not her memories, but of the other Aiko, and if he really loves her, he has to promise to save her mother and brother. Begrudgingly, Kanzaki promises to do this and no longer interfere. Shiraishi, Sagami, Sari, and Masawa reunite and they continue fighting off the matter which is now controlled by Dr. Izusa. Dr. Yuka was able to communicate with Dr. Kurose. He gives him instructions to sever the connection between Yusuka and her duplicate bodies to save the girl. Finally, Aiko and Kanzaki, or Dr. Yuka, along with Kanzaki, get to the surgery where the operation to swap Aiko's brain with the correct bodies is to be held. Kanzaki, or Dr. Yuka, places Aiko, joined by Gummy, in a pod filled with a placenta-like substance to commence the swap. Just as they're about to start the surgery, Kanzaki, or Dr. Yura, says that he cannot deny that the duplicate Aiko's existence is real and decides not to kill her. He tells her that everything will be alright and that he will take care of her. Despite the crazed Dr. Izasu's interference, the surgery was successful and the original Aiko was returned to her original body. The duplicate Aiko, albeit looking sad after being swapped, was happy that everything is back to order. She releases their mother and brother Ryota and tells Kanzaki to take care of them. After that, she shrunk back into the matter along with Gummy. After that, the entirety of the malignant matter from all around Primary Point crystallized, which marks the end of the burst. Moments later, a pod rolled in front of the team. It was the duplicate Aiko, who now had her own body thanks to Gummy having a copy of Aiko's body data. The original Aiko tells her that she will explain everything to her mom and Ryota and they can all live together. But the duplicate Aiko refuses to get in the way and wants the three of them to live without her. The original Aiko eventually respects this decision, but lets her reunite with their mother and brother for the last time. 1 year later and everyone went on living back to normal. The divers, Kanzaki, Sagami, Sari, and Masawa are doing other things. Shiraishi is back working as a researcher. And the original Aiko was back with her family, and the duplicate Aiko, who has been staying with Kanzaki, or Dr. Yuka, started anew by enrolling in school. And that was Aiko Incarnation, Season 1 Recap. If you enjoyed this recap, remember to hit that sub, click the like button, and comment down below to let me know what you think of the series. I'll see you in the next video.